The Ghana Broadcasting Corporation, GBC, will be 80 years next year, and for once, it has held its first stakeholders conference with focus on the role of the public service broadcaster in a competitive broadcasting environment. GBC wants to become the authentic and trusted voice of Ghana with a mission to lead the broadcasting and communications industry through quality programming to meet the developmental and cultural aspirations of Ghana. Again, GBC has a mission to undertake viable commercial activities that promotes the aspirations of the corporation. However, the lack of a political will to permit the state's broadcaster to realize these dreams is driving GBC to the verge of collapse.
Now, technicians and engineers have been familiar with the platform, and we have been prepared and ready for this platform since maybe 2011. However, today we are 6 months away from the deadline, and there's no platform in place. It has not been built.
He raised other concerns on the digital terrestrial TV platform.
Digital TVs will be able to pick the signals straight away. But those of us who have analog TV sets, and by our last calculation, at least 5 million Ghanaian households across the country have these. We're not going to throw these TV sets away, particularly as there is technology that will enable you convert a signal from an analog TV to a digital broadcast signal just by using what they call a set-top box. It is expected that a policy should be announced by now showing how these set-top boxes are going to be made available to the people of Ghana.
The TV license fee has for the past 23 years remained unchanged, and stakeholders believe a reasonable review will add up to internally generated funds.
This is a license fee that was fixed in 1991, 30 pesos. One sachet water, that is the fee per annum, not per day or per month, per annum. Who is going to go around and collect this kind of fee? It'll be a waste of money and time, okay? So that fee must be revised.
While agreeing to review of the TV license fees, Deputy Minister of Communications, Atu Sapon, pledged government support for GBC to fully move to the digital terrestrial television. He noted that out of 250 million cedis allocated to 17 agencies under his outfit, GBC takes 30%, and that is too much for government to bear alone.
Now, GBC on its own has 6 channels, so we need to look at if one channel is dedicated to public broadcasting. The remaining 4-5 channels could be properly commercialized, properly monetized, generate enough money that will be able to support the channel that's focused on public broadcasting.
Atu Sapon also urged GBC to develop compelling content through rebranding and develop talents to drive the content and the brand. While commending the state's broadcaster for their hard work so far, Chairman of the National Media Commission, Ambassador Cabral Blay Amihie, charged the board to afford all competitors for district assembly equal opportunities come March 2015. He warned stakeholders to also come up with a religious standard to control certain attitude of certain religious leaders on air.